Welcome back. As of April this year, suicide attempts increased by 86%, successful suicides increasing by 25%. Health and Wellness Minister Dr. Michael Dalville said on Monday, while at the health conclave at Super Clubs Breezes, that he is very concerned about the state of mental health in the Bahamas. In the past 2 weeks, there have been close to a dozen suicide attempts in Grand Bahama, Abaco, and here in the capital, with the latest involving two young females, including a 14-year-old girl that tried to cut her wrist on Sunday and a 24-year-old woman that attempted to jump from the Sydney Poitier Bridge on Saturday past. The Minister of Health noted the government has introduced new Mental Health Act or new legislation to tackle the issue, and that the act should come into force very shortly, creating an environment for better mental health services throughout the country, in addition to legislative reforms to better protect people struggling with mental health. On the crime front, four adults, three males, one female, were arrested by the police following the discovery of two unlicensed firearms and an assortment of ammunition at their Ragged Island Street residence on Tuesday. According to initial reports, shortly before 5 p.m., officers from the Drug Enforcement Unit, assisted by the K-9 unit, acting on intelligence, executed a search warrant at the residence in Coconut Grove. The search on the exterior of the residence led to the discovery of a high-powered weapon, a handgun, and an assortment of ammunition, resulting in the arrest of the occupants, a 41-year-old female, three males, ages 20, 39, and 40. The Anti-Gang and Firearms Investigation Task Force will conduct further investigations into this matter. Also from the crime beat, police are searching for two male suspects in connection with an armed robbery that occurred shortly before 10 p.m. on Tuesday off Blue Hill Road. According to preliminary reports, the victim was walking on Faith United Way when the occupants of a silver Japanese vehicle approached and two unknown males exited, one of them armed with a sharp object, robbing the victim of his personal belongings. The suspects returned to the vehicle and fled the scene, traveling west towards Blue Hill Road. If you have any information regarding this armed robbery, you are asked to contact the Criminal Investigations Department. And finally, there will be only one Valley Boys group in Category A at the 2024 Boxing Day and 2025 New Year's Day Junkanoo Parades. And it will not be the Way Forward Valley Boys, led by Trevor Davis. The Junkanoo Corporation of New Providence has made its final decision, and they recognize the world-famous Valley Boys, led by Brian Adley, who registered in March. The JCNP rejected the Way Forward's application because there was already a group registered with the name Valley Boys. The Davis-led Valley Boys have been invited to rush in the fun category, something they say they have no interest in doing, stating that they will indeed rush in the A category. The JCNP says they are working with the law enforcement agencies to ensure there is no disruption to the upcoming parades. The JCNP says it has nothing to do with the internal disputes in the Valley Boys and is only applying the rules that govern the parade. That'll do it for your JCN Evening News. Once again, I'm Jerino Saunders. Thank you so much for joining us.
This segment of the news has been brought to you by Sun Oil Limited.